Dr. Kalani Brady from the John A. Byrne School of Medicine joins us now, as he does every Thursday. Good morning, Doctor.
Good morning, Diane.
Well, we have a lot of calls this morning.
Okay.
And we'll get right to it. A caller, a woman, says she was told twice that she has congestive heart failure. What is it? What's the treatment?
Congestive heart failure, Diane, is a state where the heart does not beat as strongly as it needs to beat to maintain perfect health. There are things that we can do about it. The home remedies are salt restriction and salty foods, of course, bacon, spam, sausages, tomato sauces, prepared meats, canned foods. Those are all high in salt. The medications we use also include water pills or diuretics to get rid of salt and medications to help strengthen the heartbeat. It is a situation where we can live with congestive heart failure. We just need to treat it.
Okay. Is slipped disc surgery safe for an 83-year-old woman?
You know, I would think of it less in terms of the age of the person these days and more in terms of the biologic age. So there are 83-year-olds that are hearty and hale, and a slip disc surgery would be relatively safe for them. You don't need to worry. On the other hand, there are some people at 83 where the disc surgery may not be very safe to do. And that can be evaluated by an internist or a family practitioner in a preoperative medical evaluation.
Okay. A woman says she has severe allergies to sulfur. Oh, this sounds terrible. She gets migraines, nausea, and vertigo. Poor thing.
Is there any help
for her?
Well, the help would be obviously best to move away from an area with fog. If she lives in Kona, then that's a hard set of problems to deal with. Moving to Oahu, where we have much less trouble with VOG, would probably be an alternative. But if you have the allergy, it's not like there are medications that can magically make you better.
Oh, poor thing. For about 2 weeks, when this woman turns to the right or left, she gets dizzy and nauseated. Why?
Vertigo. And vertigo can be caused for a number of reasons. One is to go into the doctor and make sure you don't have plugged ears with wax. Another one is an ear infection. Sometimes vertigo is caused by a viral infection of the inner ear, and that just has to run its course. And there are medications to help the vertigo, but they won't shorten the course of the vertigo.
Thanks, Dr. Brady.